The World Health Organization alarmed over a significant decline in global sequencing. This comes amid its appeal to countries to continue surveillance to be able to track the movement and mutations of SARS-CoV-2.
The number of sequences shared per week has fallen by 90% since the beginning of this year, and the number of countries sharing sequences has dropped by 75%, making it so much harder to understand how the virus might be changing.
The WHO chief notes with the Northern Hemisphere approaching colder weather, more people will inevitably spend more time indoors, increasing the risk of transmission and possible hospitalization. The world body also cites an increase in global deaths in the past 4 weeks, despite the availability of tools that can protect against infection and severe disease.
15,000 deaths a week is completely unacceptable. When we have all the tools to prevent infections and save lives, we're all tired of this virus and tired of the pandemic. But the virus is not tired of us.
In the Philippines, the Department of Health logged 229 deaths from August 8 to 14. It notes, however, that almost half of the deaths occurred in the previous month. Meanwhile, independent research group Okta observes a downward trend in COVID-19 cases in the National Capital Region. In a tweet, Okta research fellow Guido David says, with 845 cases reported by the DOH last August 17, the 7-day average has declined to 1,173. However, the NCR remains to be at moderate risk as the level of infections in the region remains significant. This is why Health Officer in Charge Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere is continuously reminding the public to maintain a high level of caution. For the Health Department, it's also important to further improve the country's vaccine uptake as the world opens up. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.